Guys, today I will describe Ramachandran plot. So before moving to Ramachandran plot, we must have to have a clear idea about two points. One is the torsion angle, another is the steric hindrance. Torsion angle, in a polypeptide backbone, there are two type of torsion angle. One torsion angle is known as the psi, another is phi. This phi and psi can have value from 180 to minus 180 theoretically, but as this side chain and this non-bonded atom can also collides to each other when they are in close proximity, so at that time there will be no rotation. So all the value that is ranging in between plus 180 to minus 180 are not possible, but only a limited value of this torsion angle will be possible in case of a particular secondary protein structure. So in this diagram, when phi is 0 and psi is 180, then two oxygen atom comes at close proximity, and there will be a collision, and that collision will not allow for their rotation. And in this diagram, when phi is 180 and psi is 0, two hydrogen atom, non-bonded hydrogen atom, comes at close proximity, so this value is also not possible. And in this diagram, when both phi value and the psi value are 0, then two oxygen atom are in close contact, so that value is also not possible. So as we know that theoretically the value of pi and psi is in a range between plus 180 to minus 180, but practically it is not possible. Only a limited value of psi and phi will be possible, other value will not possible, because there will be collision or steric hindrance. That steric hindrance will not allow the rotation of the particular phi and psi torsion angle. Now in this diagram, when phi is minus 60 and psi is 180, then this is the exact orientation of the atom in the polypeptide backbone. So in this diagram we can clearly see that when phi is minus 180 and psi is plus 180, when phi is minus 60 and psi is plus 180, then the atom are far apart from each other, so there will be no restriction of rotation. So this value is possible in case of Ramachandran plot. So now if we put this value in Ramachandran plot, we can have a particular dot for a particular pair of torsion angle. Suppose I want to put this value minus 60 and 180. So where in this Ramachandran plot I will get the value? As we know, the x axis value and y axis value is represented by the phi and the psi. So when phi is minus 60, that means x is minus 60, and when psi is plus 180, that means the y is plus 180. So I have to put minus 60, 180, this value in the graph. So putting this value in the graph, we will get this box. So this box, because all the x minus, all the y is plus, so this particular box, this dot will locate. So exactly where dot will locate, then we have to locate the exact location. Easily, if we put this value in this graph, then we can see the value of phi, that is minus 60, and value of psi is 180 degree. So if I put the value minus 60 and 180, we can easily get the value is in between this location. So this dot is represented by this particular pair of torsion angle. So like this way, when a particular torsion angle have a particular type of shape And in that type of shape, if two non-bonded atoms are closely associated, then that angle is not allowed in Ramachandran plot. Rest of the angle is allowed. Again, in this diagram, when this value is phi is minus 60 and psi is 30, so this oxygen atom and this hydrogen atom is at close proximity and there is hindrance. So this value will fall in disallowed region of Ramachandran plot. So in this Ramachandran plot, when we put minus 60 and 30, we will get exact location, that is minus 60 and 30. So minus 60 and 30, that region is somehow here. So if we look in the Ramachandran plot, this place is not allowed, this place it is in disallowed region, not exactly there, this position is not allowed in Ramachandran plot, because it is just below the beta plated sheet. So this place is in blank in case of Ramachandran plot. Now yes, okay, now in this diagram I want to put the value minus 60 and 30. So minus 60 and 30, what will be the range minus 60 and 30? So 30 will be this one and minus 60 will be this one. So this place is in disallowed region. So that value, that pair of torsion angle value will not have a allowed region in the Ramachandran plot. Now if we want to put different value for torsion angle in a graph, how will we put? Suppose we want to put three value. One is for phi 30 and psi 30. So when both are 30, they will be located in this group. So for there, this particular torsion angle pair, I will get a particular type of dot. So this dot will represent by this group of torsion angle. So when phi is minus 30 and psi is plus 30, then I will get this dot. When both are negative, we will get another type of dot, that is here. When when phi is positive and psi is negative, then I will get this type of value. That means for different torsion angle, we will get a different type of dot. In particularly, a single pair of torsion angle value is represented by a single type of dot. So when we analyze the different torsion angle value for a beta plated sheet, and when we put all the value of torsion angle of that particular beta plated sheet protein, then we get this type of representation. There is numerous dot, because for every dot a single pair of torsion angle, that is allowed in case of conformation of protein. So for a beta plated sheet, we will get this type of dense dot in this particular region. That means for that particular type of protein, the torsion angle are in this value. So most of the value of torsion angle of that particular protein will be in the range of this minus 90 and plus 100. So when phi is minus 90 and psi is plus 100, so we will get this type of dot, and that dot is for a particular type of secondary structure, that is the beta plated sheet. Now for the alpha helix, the value is again in, as the right handed alpha helix is in this group, that means for the right handed alpha helix, the value of the allowed region value for the phi and the psi both are negative, because without negative value no pair of torsion angle can fall in this group or in this box. So that is why now in this diagram we can see clearly it is mentioning that when right handed helix, what is the value of right handed helix? Phi value. The phi value of right handed helix is -57 and psi value is -47. So -57 and -47, that means both are negative. So this dot, this type of dot, that means in this position there will be numerous dot in case of right handed alpha helix. In the same thing happen in left handed alpha helix, but as left handed alpha helix both are positive, so left handed alpha helix will be in this location, because this box or this small square is for both positive value of x axis and y axis. So this is left handed alpha helix. And as we can see, the maximum value of the phi is negative. So and when phi is negative and psi is positive, this group, that is why in case of parallel beta plated sheet, this negative and positive, anti-parallel beta plated sheet, negative and positive, so both parallel and beta anti-parallel will be in this location, and that location is in allowed region. And rest of the value, these are the disallowed region, because no conformation of the polypeptide backbone that have a torsion angle, that torsion angle will produce this type of dot in this disallowed location, is actually not present in nature, because as we already have seen, there will be a hindrance. So that hindrance will not allow a polypeptide backbone to have, because of that this Ramachandran plot maximum places are blank. Only 23% places of the Ramachandran plot are occupied by the allowed conformation of the different dihedral angle or torsion angle, and the rest of the places are blank. That is the reason. Again, one very interesting thing in this table, that the secondary structure of different type of protein, when we see the phi value and the psi value, so most of the phi value are in negative, because as we know in the Ramachandran plot, only these 1, 2, and 3, this region are allowed. So this region are maximum favorite region. So maximum favorite region mean the for locate in this group a particular pair of torsion angle, the phi must be negative, because if the phi value is not negative, they will not fall in this group. To fall in this group, a phi value must have to be negative. That is why in this case, the all the data in the table that is given here for the right handed alpha helix, phi is -57 and psi is -47. So both will be in this group, and parallel beta plated sheet, both will be in this group for right handed alpha helix, so both are negative. And parallel beta plated sheet, phi is -19 and psi is 113. So -19, 113, so x is negative, y is positive, so they will fall in this group. Then anti parallel beta plated sheet, phi is -139 and psi is 135, so again they will fall in this group, a little bit upper. Then anti-100 310 helix, its value is -49 for phi and -26 for psi, so again they will fall in this group. Then right-handed pi helix, the value is -57 and -70, again this will fall in this group. Then right-handed pi helix, then 2.27 ribbon, it is -78 and +59, so this will fall in this group. Then left handed polyglycine 2 and polypoline 2 helix, again it is minus and plus, so again it is in this group. Then collagen minus 51 plus 153, so again this will fall in this group. And left handed alpha helix, it is 47, so both are positive value, so this will fall in this group. But one interesting thing is why this region is no allowed region, because to be fallen in this group, a torsional pair must have the value for x axis positive and y axis negative. But in this case, x is negative, x is positive and y is negative, that is phi is positive and psi is negative, no value is according with this condition, that phi is positive, phi is positive and psi is negative, there is no value. That value will fulfill this condition for phi positive, psi negative. We can see this. When phi positive in this case, psi is also positive. That is why there will be no secondary structure of protein that will fall in this group. That is the reason this region is absolutely hindered region, absolutely blank region. Because when both pi and psi are positive, they are in this group. When pi is positive and phi is negative, when phi is positive and psi is negative, then this region will fall for this particular value. But as this orientation is not possible, because maybe in this orientation, when phi is positive and psi is negative, maybe there is more collision, maybe the atom are more closely associated in that particular value of phi and psi. That is the reason this the right hand lower region is absolutely disallowed region. But only one amino acid, that is the glycine, that will have all the four location of this Ramachandran plot, because as we know, glycine only has a ACE in their side chain, so their steric hindrance is very low. That is why glycine has four position in this polypeptide in this Ramachandran plot, whereas proline has only two position, because proline has a very peculiar type of R site. Now in this diagram, this is Ramachandran diagram of glycine residue. As we again, I want to mention this thing clearly, because this diagram shows clearly when the phi value is 90 and the psi value is minus 90, that means that particular pair of torsion angle will fall in this group. When phi is positive and psi is negative, they will fall in this group. So in this diagram, this particular value of phi and psi have a orientation like this way, and in this orientation the atom are very close proximity, so this close association of atom will have the collision. That is why this conformation in the protein is not possible in the natural world. That is why in nature there is no single protein found when this type of conformation is there within their backbone, because this type of conformation will have more steric hindrance. That most steric hindrance place will fall in the disallowed region, as there is no a single dot in any secondary structure of protein in this group. That is why this orientation is not allowed in the protein, whereas this is the most favorable conformation of protein in case of this value of pi and psi. When psi is negative, when phi is negative and the psi is positive, then this group show for that particular pair of torsion angle, and in that orientation we can easily see the atom are far apart, so there will be less restriction, less collision, less cluster between the atom. And same thing for this diagram also. This is also a very favorable conformation of protein, because in that particular value, when phi and psi both are negative, they will fall in this group, the particular dot will fall in this group. So that particular dot for both phi and psi negative value will have this orientation, and we can easily see this orientation, the atoms are far apart, so there will be less collision. As there will be less collision, there will be less steering hindrance. So that conformation will allow in the protein in natural world. That is the reason why this region are absolutely blank in Ramachandran plot, whereas this value is also absolutely blank. Only a small portion of this group is allowed, that is the left-handed alpha helical structure, when both value are positive. So this is how Ramachandran plot works. Now in this atomic model, the yellow color is the plane of peptide plane, and the red color is the oxygen atom, and the blue color is the nitrogen atom, and this black dot are the alanine amino acid side chain and their atomic van der Waals radius. And if we show the clashes when the atom are in close proximity, so this position showing the clashes, because in this position the atoms are so closely associated, so there will be clashes. So now if I change the particular value of phi or psi, so here I have fixed the phi value 165, so I will change the psi value. As I will change the psi value, I can see there will be change in the orientation of the atom, and as the atom will change its orientation, there will be new clashes or new allowed region or new disallowed region. Now at minus 171, this is absolutely allowed. Now the clashes is going on. So at that time, or that phi and psi particular value is not possible. Again, I am increasing the value of psi. Again, the clashes is increasing. So that is not possible, because in this case, I can see this oxygen atom and this alanine, the side chain atom are colliding. So the collision is going on, so that collision will not allow the atom to rotate, because every atom need a physical space to be occupied in a particular location. No two atom can overlap each other at a time. So when the atom are at closer than the van der Waals radius, then there will be collision. So as I have changed the psi value, you can see the hindrance region is increasing, decreasing according to the orientation of atom. Now I will show you the phi value, how the phi angle, change of the phi angle will also have this type of collision. So this is the orientation. So I will change the this phi value. Yeah, this phi value, I am decreasing the value of phi. Yes, as I am decreasing the value of phi, the torsion angle is changing. As torsion angle is changing, the hindrance is also getting changed. So now at this particular position, that is absolutely full hindrance, because these two atoms are in close proximity. So this value of psi and the phi is not possible in Ramachandran plot. But as this is changing, as I am changing the value in the right hand side, you can see, so the clashes between the atom is also changing. So there will be particular value for phi and psi when there will be no clashes. So I am moving towards that goal, when that phi value will not have any clashes. So yes, I am just changing the value of phi, and as you can see in this atomic model, the clashes is also changing, because as the angle value of the phi is changing, that means the torsion angle is also changing. As the torsion angle is changing, that means the orientation of atom in the space is also changing. As the orientation changes, the collision is changing. Now there is absolutely no collision, because we cannot see any collision between atom, because in this conformation atom are far apart from each other. So when phi is minus 15 and psi is minus 75, at that value there is no collision. So this value is possible in Ramachandran plot. So if we put this value, we will get it in which location? We will get in the lower left, that is the both minus. So it will absolutely, this figure is for right handed alpha helix or some yes, only the right hand alpha helix fall in that group. So this conformation is absolutely for right hand alpha helix, because in the right hand alpha helix we can see they are in the lower left side. So in the lower left side, when both value are negative, and so this negative value is showing no collision. So that is why that reason are possible in case of Ramachandran plot, why the alpha helix, right hand alpha helix fall in that group, because that group no collision. You can see when both are negative, maximum region are allowed region. So yes, as it is changing now, it will go to yes, still there is no collision. So maximum negative value for phi is possible, because in maximum negative value for phi there is no collision. So if we put, now collision start. So when it increasing to positive value, the collision started. So this is how Ramachandran plot is predicted. When we put the positive value of phi, there will be collision. So how we can calculate this? Because we just measure the distance between the atom, we can easily calculate this, whether this torsion angle is possible or not. So by this way, we can easily measure the secondary structure of unknown protein just by putting this torsion value in the Ramachandran plot. So this is a very huge discovery. This is a huge discovery, though it is a fundamental discovery, it has a great application, because without knowing the X-ray crystallography structure, I can predict the structure of an unknown protein, whether it is a beta plated sheet or whether it is an alpha helix. So I can see that when I am changing to positive value of phi and fixing the psi value at minus, there is maximum region or unallowed region, because the positive value is not allowed, because positive value, when the positive value of phi is there, that time the atoms are in close proximity, so there will be hindrance. As I am changing the value to negative, you can see here, yes, this is allowing region. Is as it is moving to negative value, it is allowing, so there is no hindrance. Yeah, now when phi is minus 19, no hindrance. So like this way, we can measure that which value will be allowed in Ramachandran plot and which will be in disallowed region or hindrance region in this Ramachandran plot. So maximum value for minus, both minus, that is possible. That is why we can see, we already have seen in the Ramachandran plot, the maximum places when both x-axis value and y-axis value, that is the phi and psi, are negative, that region is possible. That is the reason why this region is possible, because in this conformation there is no steric hindrance, as we already have seen in this molecular diagram of peptide bond. So thank you guys, hope you have cleared the concept of Ramachandran plot after watching this atomic model. So it is absolutely free in website. You can go in website and you can get it of your own animation. So this is a pretty awesome thing. Thank you guys, thank you so much. If you want to know the name of the website, please comment in the comment section. I will give you the name of the website. So to watch that website, to log into that website, you can easily make your own animation. You can put your own value and you can see whether that value is allowed or not, whether that value is possible is or not. So this is a pretty awesome thing. So I am very amazed to Ramachandran plot. For the last 2 days I am studying Ramachandran plot. Believe me guys, I am tried every possible way to make you people understand a little bit better Ramachandran plot, because to me this discovery is absolutely a genius discovery, because without knowing the X-ray crystallographic structure, we can determine the value we can determine the conformation of a unknown protein. This is absolutely a genius thing that G.N. Ramachandran has did for us long way back in 1963 while he was studying the conformation of protein, the collagen triple helix. That time he has faced so many problems. To keep the answer of those problems, he has come to this awesome concept, the Ramachandran plot. So to be an Indian, this is our proud moment, because this is the only thing that is present in a MSc level book, that's the Indian scientist fundamental research is there in the textbook in the biochemistry classes. So for me, this was a extraordinary discovery. That is why I love Ramachandran plot very deeply. That is why I have made this video, and I have tried my level best to make you people understand in every possible way. If there is any mistake in the video, please write in the comment section, because I am also student. I also learn by mistake. So your criticism is always welcome. So thank you guys, thank you for watching, and please subscribe my channel so that every time I post a new video and you get notification and you don't miss it. Thank you.